Hello everyone, and welcome back to Single Player Survival. I'm Jiikxor, and yeah, so I did get back from the cave alive, as you can see, because I still have 38 levels. Or not still have, but I have 38 levels. So this is our haul. I did go back into it a little bit today and get some more stuff, but yeah, I did find more diamonds after the fact, and there are some still down in the cave that I'd like to mine with a fortune pick. But yeah, we got 3 stacks of iron. Well, actually we got over 4 stacks of iron because we cooked some of it. This right here. We got 56 gold, 7 diamonds, and then I know where more are in the cave. But like I said earlier, I'm waiting for a fortune pick, 36 blocks of redstone, a stack and 7, and then 61 blocks of lapis lazuli. Additionally, we also got 2 music discs, 3 music discs, iron horse armor, I got some obsidian, got 2 name tags, so yeah, it was a pretty good caving expedition. There is one thing I'd like to do right now here. Let's go in here, make some of that. So I did a little bit of work on the basement. I think what I'm going to do is just have like this room here, and then do corridors going off, and then I'll just do that downwards depending on, or as I need more rooms. But let's get this baby crafted. Aww, yeah, enchanter. Okay, so we don't have the bookshelves yet. I did do a little bit of animal farming to get some leather, so I do have some. I have 10, but I don't believe that gets us to level 30, which is what I'd like to enchant. So let's just do that. Okay. Okay, we're at level 20, 22. Wait, hang on. Okay, so let's just break these just in case they're blocking. I don't think they are. Just in case. 20, 20, 20. Okay, yeah. We definitely need more levels, or bookshelves rather. So, I have done a bit of farming on the past, and I got these, but it takes a lot of leather. Also, you can see how much steak I have. But yeah, it takes a lot of leather to make bookshelves. But in order to get leather, I think I don't really want to kill all the population of my cows. I just barely refarmed them all, or rebred them after killing a bunch. So let's head, let's see, I believe it was east. Let's head to the savanna biome and see if we can find any cows there and kill those instead. I haven't explored this one yet. I only saw it from a distance, so this will be neat. I should have made a boat prior to coming here, but this time I'll remember to do it before I actually leave this shore. So here we go, going on a wild adventure. I have a bed in case I need to sleep the night away. Almost guarantee I will need to. Let's get our last piece of bread, pick up our crafting table. Okay, and yeah, there we go. Now we got some real food. I've done a lot of expansion on Hungry Island. I planted the potatoes and carrots we got. Generation lag. I planted the potatoes and carrots we got dirt going caving, so. Can I throw the needle? Oh, snap. I totally did it. Alright. Oh. Okay, one thing I'd like, can I not, oh, just kidding, my boat is gone. I'd like to grab one of these saplings so I can use it in builds. So let's just grab that real quick. I love these acacia trees, they're so cool. Okay, I got some acacia wood. Oh good, sapling dropped, let's replant that. Because I don't want to, like, destroy the environment here. Let's just wait for one more. But yeah, like I said earlier in an episode, it's called Savannah, right? Savannah, yeah. Savannah biomes are my favorite biomes. I like them a lot, just the way they look. And okay, two acacia saplings. That should be enough. I don't know, I want one more. One more acacia sapling. But yeah, I love these biomes. See if we can't help it along a little bit. Just more sapling, that's all I want. Come on, buddy. There we go. Cool. Okay, now let's go exploring. So our goal here is just to explore, see what kind of cool stuff this place has, and maybe find a couple cows and get them. Get their leather. Immediately we have sheep. Not quite what I wanted, sheep. But they are useful in the snapshot. I won't spoil it for anyone who doesn't know what's in the snapshot, but they aren't completely useless. Okay, what is... Oh, we're at 87. That's pretty high up. Savannah Plateau. Oh, sweet. We got a plateau biome. Or Savannah Plateau, rather. Okay. So it seems like the plateau section is just this right here. I do kind of want to build something in this biome. I think that'd be cool. Maybe like a fortress or a castle up on that hill. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. So let's continue forward. All I see right now is a lot of sheep. Chickens! Ooh. Let's see, what are these cords? Should be around here. I need chickens because I don't have any on my island. Maybe you can swing by right there and find some eggs. Okay. Just like this flat plains area with just a couple trees scattered about. Oh! Oh, is this another island? Oh. Okay. I didn't realize this would be another island. I thought it would be more like the swamp biome and be an actual landform. Huh. I'm gonna sleep this nighttime away. Ugh. Ta-da! Okay. For my first trick, I will make the night turn today. Well, so we have another island here. This is a really cool seed. I like it. I wonder if... Is that part of the section we already explored, or is that... What's this? Oh. Love that. Make it sand foam. It's the best thing. Okay. So let's go over this way, that to the right a little bit over there. I think we've already... Haven't we already explored this? I swear we have. Or did we not? It almost looks like it's generating as we're walking. I'd like to find out if this place actually is an island. Because that would be pretty cool. I like islands and just the feeling of being secluded that you get from them. Okay. Oh. Oh, this is where we came from. That's why those leaves look like they were generating. Huh. And did we go all the way to the right here? Quit. So it looks like we're gonna have to do a little bit more exploring if we want to find... Oh, hang on, what's this? Is this another island? Where's my boat? It's back there, huh? Seeds. Okay, let's go grab my boat. If it's still there. And then... We can go explore that other island over there. Don't want to do too much exploring. Because there are some other things I'd like to get done this episode, but... Let's see. Does shooting the boat work? I think it does, but I don't really want to waste arrows. There we go. Now it broke. I suppose I didn't really need to break it. I could have just gotten into it and then... Right, here we go. Let's see what this island is. Maybe it's just like a tiny, tiny island. Oh, there's a little bit more. Okay. Are we not completely... Oh, okay. I thought it wasn't an island, but it is. Maybe? Question mark? Okay, I just had to do something, but magic editing, it didn't take a long time. Okay, so it looks like there's a desert? Maybe? Possibly? There's cactus here, and I'd like to grab that. Ooh. Ooh, floating sand, floating sand. Where did my boat go? Boat? Boat? That's all that's left. It's just a stick. Why? Oh, okay, there is the rest of it. Ooh. Good stuff. Okay. So we might find a desert temple in this biome. Oh, I just realized there's also villages. Two, aren't there? Yeah. Okay. So we're seeing a lot more land generate. I think that's a different savanna biome. I want to explore this desert a little bit more. There's like a floating thing right there in the sky, which is pretty cool. I don't want to touch that. But I do like how islandy this seed is. It's pretty neat. Hopefully there's an NPC village here. That would be pretty good. They can be pretty hidden though. Like if I'm not careful. I can miss them easily. They can be like completely buried and just have like a couple blocks of sandstone showing. Oh, is this a roofed forest? Forest? Oh. Okay, there's a plains here. Yes! A village! And it's in a savanna! Yes! Alright, let's explore this thing a little bit. And it has a blacksmith. What are we gonna get? What are we gonna get? I don't think we'll get anything too useful. Because I pretty much have most things that I need, but... Oh. I didn't mean it. I mean, I would have taken more useful stuff if you had offered it to me, village. Alright. I'm just gonna light this area up real quick. And then leave it. Before it gets nighttime and any zombies spawn. I don't really want the villagers to die. Because that would be sad. Which what I probably should do is just block the doors up. Alright, I'm gonna get the coordinates. Okay. Some lava right here. Some pigs who like to live dangerously. Alright. I'm probably gonna get hopelessly lost. Seems like we've done a pretty good amount of exploring. Oh, cows. Yes. These cows are going to die. Or should I leave them? Huh. Huh. I might settle here. Like, and make a castle, because it's right next to the NPC village. And I might not want to have to take cows all the way. Yeah, let's leave those cows behind us. Ooh, brown sheep. Hi, brown sheep. Okay. Let's head home. I'm not exactly sure what the coordinates for home are. So, I'm just kind of guessing. We did head east from my house, so hopefully going west brings us back. I mean, once I find some landmarks, then I can pretty easily find my way home. But didn't I just come from the? Of course, I was that way. Like I came. Where did I go to the village from? Which direction? I don't know. I'm so confused. What time is it? I really don't want mobs to spawn around this village, because that would not be cool. Ooh, pumpkins. Those could be useful. So let's just grab these. I guess I'd like to also grab a sapling for this type of wood. The roofed forest. Dark oak. Oh! I think we have found a dungeon. Or a really dark cave. That sounded like a dungeon to me though. Cause like, the second I got into the area, there were zombies going wow. That sun. The second it goes down, I need to sleep. Prevent any spawning. I guess I don't need to chop down the whole tree to get a sapling, right? I just can break these. Come on, give me a sapling. Of course, I might as well chop this thing down. There we go. First, don't you need four of these? You need four of these, right? Can I sleep now? No. Okay. Can I sleep now? No. Okay. Can I sleep now? No. Okay. How about now? No. Okay. How about now? I believe I can only sleep in the afternoon. Now. Go back. Now, yes! Alright, hopefully we don't see any mobs spawning. I don't see any, so it looks like we're good. Hooey. So this is cool though. We got a village, we got a dark, roofed forest. We got all the things. Man, never watch. We didn't find any cows though, so that's... Well, we did, but we didn't want to kill them. Because we may have need for them in the future. Nah. That was my evil scientist voice. Strikes fear into the heart of everyone who hears it. Okay. Well. I think I'm going to cut right here, and I'll return when I get back to the house, unless I find anything else interesting. So yeah. Alright guys, I am back, and I've done a little bit more farming, so I have two more bookshelves. Well, I guess I did more than just to get the two, because we just need these last two. So, first thing I'm going to enchant is a fresh diamond pickaxe, hopefully getting fortune. The last bookshelf's in, ba-da-da-da! Yay! Okay, so, do we do it? This could be a really good one, could be terrible. Let's do it. Alright, come on, fortune 3. Oh, silk touch. That's not bad. That's not good either, but you know, silk touch is not terrible. It's pretty useful, actually. I'm not mad. Just kidding. Okay. Cool, so we have a silk touch pick that'll make gathering stone easier, and just resources in general. So yeah, we finally have an enchanting table. Doing a lot of work to get that. I would like to say I'm going to make this room look a lot nicer than it is now, because right now it does not look very good, but yeah, it's going to look fancy. So, yes. I'm going to put this pick in here real quick. I'm going to put this pick in here real quick. Hey, that rhymed. Alright. Some more cows here. They didn't have to face the mighty iron sword of Jiikxor. Okay. So, I'm going to be doing something with this today. And it's going to be pretty useless, other than to just be funny or interesting. I'm going to call it the Sheep of Eater. Let's see, I'm trying to think how I can do this. Let's see, that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. 14 or so. Okay. I think I'll share my plan. So, you might have been able to guess from me calling it the Sheep Evader, but my plan is to have, like, something hanging from this platform here that, like, sheep go in it, they fall down, I'll have, like, a hole with a sign, so the sheep fall down in there, they're pushed up a water stream, and then go up, and it's just an infinite loop of sheep just going down and up and down, and I think it'll be pretty cool. We could call it, like, a sheep fountain. Yeah, sheep fountain, that's better than Sheep Evader. So, that's my plan. Also, I'll show you guys Sheep Island. I've done some breeding there as well with the animals. Got them, so there's the sheep, because it's Sheep Island, so, you know. I guess you could probably assume that I was, or sheep live there. Anyway, I've been doing a bunch of breeding over there, so I have pretty much an army of sheep. It's like, oh, there's just one, two over there, Jiikxor. No. No, there is not. It's called Sheep Island for a reason. I've got a huge herd of sheep now. And I already knew this before, but I had forgotten it. But when you breed... Oops, sorry, guy. When you breed a white sheep with a dark gray sheep, you get light gray. Yay, now you know. That's Hungry Island. It's doing great. Yes. You sheep won't even know what to hit you. So, I think I'm going to start working on that off camera because it probably won't be too exciting. Yeah. I will be back when I've made a little bit of progress on it. Or maybe just when I get myself all ready to get started on it. So yeah. Let's get working. Welcome back, everyone. It's been a couple days since I recorded the last couple clips, and I've done quite a bit of work. I think I'm pretty much finished with it. We just gotta do some testing. I'm gonna test with cows because I have a lot of them on this island, so just gotta get this cow guy up into this tunnel here, and this will tell us whether or not it's working. So I guess I'll just show you with the cow. Come here, guy. Up into the tunnel, it's nice and friendly. There you go. Uh-oh. Come on, cow. You can do it, buddy. Let's see, how can I get this to work? Huah! I need to get him to fall down that hole. I'm gonna put some torches down, make sure it's lit. Let's see. I guess we could just lead him off. Or push him off. Let's grab some cobblestone so I can go to the side. Okay. Now come here, cow. Ah, you didn't say that. Beef? Totally not eating your kind. It's okay. We're fine. Okay. Alright. Just come to this nice, lovely platform. Oops. There we go. Okay. So now, we should hopefully have the cow going throughout the thing. So, let's just sit here and we will wait. And if we see pieces of beef, then we will know it did not work. This actually probably is not a safe spot. Cow? Cow? This spot makes me uncomfortable. Where's the cow? Oh no. Did he not make it? Uh-oh. Well, there he is. Ah! Alright. Yay. So that's basically how it will work. Except I will have sheep in it, not cows. I did have to do a little bit of work on this section here. I'm going to replace this dirt with stone. I just didn't have any on me. Unless I did. Nope, I didn't. Okay. So yeah, that's what I'm going to do. But that's basically what it does is they go up. They fall down here. I can show you guys too. So they fall down to here. They go in here. Pushes them this way. And then they go up here. This is all source blocks. Up through the entire thing. So they can go up faster. Takes them around this corner. And then up here. Working with like sheep and cows, and I believe pigs and chickens are probably the same way as well, is kind of difficult because they get caught on the sign. Or like if you try to do the sign water like you can do with like experience farms with zombies and skeletons, it doesn't work because I guess they're only like half a block and a half tall. So when they try to go up, they can't make it past the sign. I don't know entirely how they work, but yeah. So that's it, pretty much. All I need to do is just add the sheep. I lost that sign. All I need to do is add the sheep, and we'll have a working sheep fountain. So I think I'm going to do that off camera real quick, and then I'll show you the finished product. Alright everyone, welcome back. I think I've finally done at least the start of it. I should get a couple of sheep in there, so I'm just gonna sit here and wait till they show up. These cows are such a pain because they kept wanting to come with the wheat. So yeah, I just had to like hit them away, so a lot of them are probably pretty low health, which is not good. I actually killed a couple.
I've killed a couple cows, and
but yeah, that does kind of stick out, which I was hoping it wouldn't, but you know, this is cool, so I think it's worth it, but just gonna, eventually I'm gonna get more sheep into this, but I just wanted to get, I think I have around 6 or so in it now, so yeah, just sitting here waiting. They all like come in groups of like 3 or so. Maybe you have more than 6. I don't know. I would have thought one would come sooner. Let's see if I can capture the action. I wonder if the sheep are drowning. Oh. Alright, I guess let's go investigate. Because there were at minimum 6 sheep in there. Oh. Uh-oh. Well, that's sad. It was working a second ago. Like, sheep falling on my head. Okay, well, I think you probably got the basic idea of what it does. Before next episode, I'll get it working again. Those flowers remind me so much of Earth. I keep thinking those flowers are creepers, because every time I see them, it's like, but they're not really creepers. So, yeah, that's the sheep fountain. Doesn't actually work yet, but it will eventually once I get it working. I wonder if it had to do with me holding the wheat. I will investigate more, but this episode's running on a pretty long amount of time, so I'm going to call it here. Thank you everyone for watching. I will see you all later.